Hello, good morning everyone. Welcome to the second day of DERMACON 2020. Today with me is our senior dermatologist from Pune, Dr. Dilip Shah. Good morning, sir. Welcome to DERMACON.
Good morning, Pradyumna. Good morning.
So how was your yesterday's day, sir? Day one of DERMACON.
Oh, day one of DERMACON was excellent. Let us start from the beginning itself. Yes. When we came, we arrived just outside the venue. There was a tremendous traffic jam, but that was expected. And people were well dressed, they were wearing their badges, but the thing was that it was crowded. We tried to manage the crowd. We had talked to the police department earlier also, and then today the things have improved. But as soon as you enter the premises, it was a very pleasant feeling.
Did you feel that you are walking in a pandal, or you are in any of the five-star hotel or like an airport lounge?
Yes, that was after entering the premises. But before you enter, the way you have put the photographs, the way you have made the decor around the entrance.
Showcase the Pune
culture. Yes, that was excellent. And then it was something new. We have been attending all the conferences all these years. But then this was a real innovative idea, and I must congratulate you for that.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. But how was your registration experience?
Exactly. That's what I was going to come to you. Because what we expect every time is the tremendous chaos at the registration counter. But this time, when people and the delegates, when they entered, it was such a pleasant experience that you have many counters, there was no chaos, the girls sitting on the counter were very well trained, and they were very polite, and the job was done in just 2 minutes.
Great.
Not only that, the pleasant atmosphere, you had put enough sofas, it's like a five-star lounge. I mean, you didn't feel that you have come for the national conference.
Thank you. And how about the going from one place to other place? Though it was slight far off, but we tried to segregate a few areas, like trade and the registration area was in one area, then scientific area was in other particular part, and food area was in a particular part. So this segregation, was it beneficial from the delegate point of view?
100%, because you know, when you enter the registration, immediately you have an entrance for the trade exhibition. And it was so good. I mean, the minute you looked at the premises, you felt that it's one of those standard trade exhibitions we attend international conferences.
Yes.
And then not only that, clean and meticulous. The AC was working so well. There was no problem with that. Plus the structure which they put there, few stalls, but very meticulously done. Few representatives on each stall. There was no crowd. And then the directions which you had written in the trade exhibitions, that means from trade, you can enter to any scientific session halls. The signs were meticulous. They were very, very, one can say that the directions were absolutely proper.
Yes. And did you attend scientific sessions? And which one you liked the most? I attended a few because of my administrative things. I couldn't attend more. But I attended the oration, Ambadi oration. And I feel it was one of the best orations till now we have seen in DERMACON.
Yeah, because that was on the innovation in dermatosurgery.
Yes.
And then Dr. Ashik, I attended that session. In fact, I was sitting there. And then simple things, how you can use it in your practice. You need not spend too much.
Yes.
And you should have that approach and the brain to innovate the things.
And he put it very nicely.
Very nicely. In fact,
that was also innovative.
Innovative. You saw the dressing, how you made it.
Yes.
Just from the gloves, you could put it and you don't have to spend much for
and
that.
And the attendance was also amazing.
Oh, the hall
all
was
the
full.
Scientific halls were full, and especially during the oration, the capacity of that hall is almost 2,000 and everything was jam-packed.
Yes, it was packed and then the selection for Ambadi oration was also, I must say that it's a unique experience to attend that lecture.
From delegate point of view, how you feel the scientific program has shaped up?
I know, Pradyumna, you have been working on it yourself, scientific committee chairman, Dr. Bide, and then Narendra, for last 2 years. And then the selection of international speakers, the selection of local speakers, the acceptance of the paper, and because you know that every conference you get hundreds of papers coming, and to select from them, it's not only that, some people do get disappointed with that their paper is not accepted, and it's a big job for the scientific committee to select the papers. But what I feel and what I gather from all the delegates is that almost all the halls, all the papers par excellence, and they really enjoyed it.
Yes,
they really.
And I was also surprised because I got a feedback like early in the morning at 8:30 we started the session, and leprosy session was the first, and there was also jam-packed hall.
Yes, yes, jam-packed hall. The session was too good. In fact, yesterday also few panel discussions, they ran short of time because
yes,
discussion was so scientific and to the point, and people were enjoying it. People were enjoying
it. This time, what we had decided. See, sometimes few people overshoot the time. Now, this time we had decided we are going to close off the monitors.
Yes.
Immediately, once they finish their time slot.
Yeah.
So, what you feel, this should be implemented in all the conferences, or it was slightly harsh on the presenters?
Not at all, not at all. Because the speakers have been instructed that you have been given 15 minutes or 30 minutes. They have been preparing on those papers for last 1 year. So, they know that they have to fix that time and they have to deliver their lecture within that 30 minutes.
And because of that also, we could finish all the scientific program on time.
Otherwise, you have seen many of the conferences, the scientific program goes out until 7 o'clock, 7:30, and then suddenly you have to go for the entertainment
yes.
program, which becomes really, it's taxing on the delegates because they come at 8 o'clock in the morning. So this was very good, and it should be followed in all the conferences that yes, once the time slot is over, is there. Plus one more thing I like, plenary session, there was no question and answer because you invite a guest speaker. He is going to deliver to you. He has put his life into that paper.
Yes.
And then we start asking them question. It's not fair.
Yes.
Because yesterday's pathogenesis of psoriasis in Hall A. Fortunately, I was chairing the session. I was lucky to chair the session. And what I could see that the way they work, and people were really enjoying it.
So we could have their experience also. The international experience was also beneficial for our delegates.
100%. Not only that, our hospitality. Because you see that when we go for World Congresses or EADV or AAD, nobody is bothered about you. I'm very frank with you.
Yes.
But here, the way we take care of our delegates, we take care of our guest speakers, we take care of our delegates coming from other countries. I mean, it's something which they really like it, they enjoy it, and the way we respect them for all the things.
After the scientific, what you means, did you attend our surprise item which was done by the committee members, the flash mob?
Yes, that was too good. That was too good. And then the way the girls were dancing, it was putting a real spirit to all the delegates.
Yeah, that was for the energy kind of a thing.
Of course.
So of all us, because academics are, yes, that is the priority of all the conferences.
Yes.
But yes, some change, some slightly different kind of a thing. It brings more energy
to
the whole of the, and a positive environment around.
Yes, and something different from the scientific session. All the delegates were on their cameras, video recording the dance, and they were really enjoying it. Not only that, the other thing, the procession, what you put for Veer Savarkar,
the cultural. See, we try to show all the luminaries from Maharashtra. Right from Shivaji Maharaj to Bajirao Peshwe to Sant Jnaneshwar, Tukaram, to the Jyotiba Phule, Dr.
Yes.
Baba Saheb Ambedkar.
Yes,
so
yes.
That kind of, so people should know where they have come, what is their history.
Yes, especially,
and we should project that.
Correct, especially the Jnaneshwar procession with those kids with mrudanga and tal. It was a unique
experience. People enjoyed taking selfies with them and all.
Lokmanya Tilak, almost I felt that really Lokmanya is
walking.
It was
a live character.
Yes, what we could see there. Let's come down to the food part of it.
Yes.
I mean, very well.
Because most of the times people are not happy. There is no variation or there is a lot of crowd. So what was your experience yesterday?
No. Crowd, you see, because we have too many delegates. In spite of making all the meticulous arrangements, at that particular time, it's going to be crowded anywhere. I mean, like the Hall A session, you said that we have 5,000 delegates and we have 3,000. So it's going to get crowded. That way, that particular time, but the food quality was too good. The arrangements were meticulous. Not only that, yesterday's program, especially the bar, you had kept so many counters. I mean, people were really happy and there was no chaos at the bar. Otherwise, usually food counters are empty and the bar is crowded. But this time we found that people were really enjoying it. The entertainment program was good. Food quality was also good. Arrangements were good. And the cleanliness which
good.
I really liked. After using the plates, they had kept a separate counter to put those plates. And then even the crockery was clean. Everything was par excellence. Really, they have put their heart into it.
So, this was the recap of yesterday, what we had in DermaCon 2020 on the first day. Today also, it is going to be an exciting day. There are a lot of good sessions. There are orations today. Then there is important function, which is the IDVL day today. So, please attend in large numbers. We are going to felicitate our own members who have done a tremendous job. during their tenure or in spite of their working schedule, they have contributed to the IDWL, and we are going to felicitate them. So please attend in large numbers in Hall A. Then there is going to be an oration, plenary sessions. There also you come in large numbers. All other scientific areas, please download the app. There are all the information is written on the app. And you can just click, you can just put, this is my favorite, and a reminder will be sent to you through the app so that you will not miss that session. So downloading the DermaCon app is also important. Then in the evenings, we are having, again, cultural program. The cultural program is going to start at 6:30. From 6:30 to 7:30, there is a unique program which is called as Drums of Peshwa, where we are going to showcase all the percussion instruments of Maharashtra, and followed by a scintillating performance of Shalmali Kholgade, 7:30 onwards. It is going to be a mix and match of tradition to technology. The food is also going to be there, cocktails are going to be there. So please come in the evenings in large numbers. Mornings, yes, I know all the halls are running full, so I'm not inviting you for that. Definitely you are going to attend the academic session. One more thing which I would like to tell you, there is a pledge which has been designed by SIG Leprosy, and that pledge and a flex we have kept in between near the preview room. So you please all go there and sign that pledge. We are trying to make a record out of that. So 4,500 delegates that are dermatologists signing a pledge on a signboard in 1 or 2 days, that is going to be a record. So please go there and sign yourself and read that pledge and try to implement in your routine practice. With all this, I will try to again welcome you all on the second day of DermaCon 2020, and please enjoy and learn a lot on day two of DermaCon 2020. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Once again, congratulations. You have done an excellent job, and God bless you.
Thank you.
Thank you.